In LabVIEW 2012, there are some slick new features for processing the outputs of tunnels from structures. The one we'll look at today is concatenating arrays. To understand why this is valuable, let's uncover the past and take a look at how LabVIEW used to process arrays being output from structures. For instance, if I put down a for loop, take my iteration terminal and wire it to the border, I'll get an indexed tunnel, and I can create an indicator off of this. If I run this 5 times, then my array will have 5 elements. Now what if I nest these for loops and put another for loop around this and wire this array to the border of the outer loop, create an indicator, and also have this run 5 times, what do I get? Well, we see that automatically I get a 2D array where each row is a full 5 iterations of the inner loop. Now that may be what I want, but what if instead of creating a 2D array, I actually just want to keep the 1D array and add the new elements onto it? In other words, concatenate onto the original array. Now I could always do that in LabVIEW with the build array function and shift registers. But now in LabVIEW 2012, it's much easier because I have a special type of tunnel for that. Let's pull this over a bit and I'll branch off of this array to the border. And instead of the default auto index tunnel, I'll right click on this, go to tunnel mode, and we see that indexing is checked by default, but instead I'll choose concatenating. And we see the little glyph changes. And if I right click on this and create an indicator, we see first off that we have a 1D array instead of the 2D array. And if I run this and expand this, what do I see? Well, to make it easier, I'll right click on the border of the array, go to visible items, vertical scroll bar, and be able to see all the elements of the array. And what we have is each iteration of the outer for loop being just concatenated onto the original array. So we go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times total. So if I have a situation where I want to be checking some piece of data to see if it fits in a threshold value, and if it does, I want to append that to the array, this could be a good way to do that. There's a nice new example in the example finder. Called find out of range elements. Here we go. And we can see on the block diagram that it's using the concatenate array's output tunnel. And we see another type of tunnel here that you may not have seen, and that's the conditional tunnel, which we'll talk about in the next episode of the iHi. So come on back.